funding for the Sagamore and funding for the board bridges. I'm joined here today by Congressman Bill Keating in his congressional district. And I also want to give my special thanks to Colonel John Catalano, who is with us. He's the deputy is in charge of the Corps. Scott Acone, Janet, Eric, Michelle, and the entire team of the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers for hosting us today here at the Sagamore Bridge. Thank you to the bipartisan legislative leaders who also joined us today, who not only reach across the aisle every day to advocate for the Commonwealth, but also happen to live on both sides of the bridges. Senator Sue Moran of Delmar, Representative Steve Ixaros of Barnesville, Representative Matt Muratori of Plymouth, and Representative Kathy Lenatra of Kingston, and Representative Tim Whalen from Brewster. All here today, all big supporters of this project, and ultimately this is going to have to be a federal, state, and local partnership if it's going to be successful. I am also glad that we can be joined by Paul Nitzwicki, CEO of the Cape Cod Chamber of Commerce. It's always a pleasure to be at the Cape Cod Canal, and today I'm proud to bring great news. We're making major progress on the infrastructure investments that we need in this region. One could say we're building a bridge to a better future for Cape Cod. On August 10th, the Senate approved a $1.2 trillion bipartisan infrastructure bill that will help update our roads, our bridges, rail, and transit systems all across the Commonwealth of Massachusetts. A day later, we passed in the Senate a $3.5 trillion budget resolution that will unlock transformational investments in the well-being of both our families and our planet while delivering a massive tax cuts to working families in our country. This legislation will be our way to level the playing field across our country, slash child poverty, and address the existential crisis of the climate threat to Cape Cod and to the planet. Today, I'm proud to announce that we were successful in the Senate in securing nearly $8 billion for Massachusetts in the bipartisan infrastructure bill. $8 billion. Of that $8 billion, $1.1 billion will be dedicated to replacing and repairing bridges like the Bourne and the Sagamore Bridge, which is, again, right over my shoulder. $4.2 billion will be for updating our roads and our highways. $2.5 billion will go to enhancing transit systems like the Cape Cod Regional Transit Authority. $63 million will be for electric vehicle charging infrastructure. And at least $100 million, with hundreds of millions more later, will go to broadband access so that every community can be connected to our digital world. And I do know, because I get the phone calls, many people on Cape Cod are not happy with their broadband access, but putting in hundreds of millions of dollars in order to rectify that problem. In addition, I'm delighted that this infrastructure bill also includes nearly $1.5 billion for coastal resiliency and flood mitigation, which is an important down payment on the investments we need to protect vulnerable regions here on Cape Cod, but all across the country. Because each and every one of the communities along the Cape, in fact, are being subjected to the threats of climate change, and we need to build in the funding that helps them to prepare for the resiliency they'll need for the decades ahead. And lastly, but certainly not least, I'm very proud that this infrastructure package includes two other programs that will help advance one of Massachusetts' most critical projects, replacing both the Cape Cod Canal bridges. As everyone here knows, the Bourne and the Sagamore bridges are vital parts of the Cape's economy and their way of life, connecting the residents of this region to the rest of Massachusetts and serving as an evacuation route in the worst case emergency situations. Unfortunately, these two bridges are also over 80 years old, structurally deficient, and in desperate need of replacement. That's why I work very hard to ensure that the bipartisan infrastructure bill includes the escape patterns that I authored and introduced with Senator Warren and Congressman Keenan. Our legislation will dedicate $140 billion to improving, fortifying, or replacing life-saving evacuation routes, including finding obvious life in the Canal Bridges. On top of that, the infrastructure bill also includes the Bridge Investment Act legislation that I jointly introduced and fought to pass. This program will provide $12.5 billion as a grant program to assist state, local, and federal entities with bridge replacement and rehabilitation projects. This program was inserted on the Infrastructure Committee in the Senate, on which I sit, fighting to make sure that the revenues are there that can be used by the Commonwealth, by the Cape. And importantly, the bill also makes sure that the Army Corps, the owner of the canal bridges, and Massachusetts can work together to compete for funding to complete our vital bridge project here on Cape Cod. And finally, this bill will give substantial funding directly to the Army Corps with an infusion of $4 billion for its operations and maintenance and $11.6 billion for its construction projects. There really has not been a piece of legislation like this moving through the United States Congress for generations. And amongst all those various programs and funding sources, I know that we can deliver two new bridges for the people of Cape Cod and Massachusetts. And I know, as I speak for my colleagues, Senator Warren and Senator Keating, when I say that once this bill becomes law, we stand ready to help advance this essential project at the federal level, along with our state legislative partners who are joining us here today. We've still got work to do in Washington to get both the bipartisan infrastructure package and the budget resolution across the finish line. But this has already been one of the most consequential periods in the history.
We are the most affected by the Army Corps. We work together closely. The cooperation and prioritizing the issues is essential to our district. We greatly appreciate it. appreciated. Came in late last night from our session yesterday and came back home. And here, not only representing the Commonwealth, but also this district in Congress, but I'm also a resident of Bourne who lives just a few minutes away from the Bourne Bridge. I'd like to thank Selectman Seymour for his year and representing Bourne for your participation. I live here, I deal with the current bridges, and I've dealt for years with which direction we're going to go. Looking back over this period of time, we spent several years in meetings with the Army Corps and also being joined by the Baker administration. And I can tell you that talking to the governor and meeting with the governor, this is one of his, if not his, primary infrastructure priority as well. And we worked for years going back through the planning of this. And during that period of time, it was inescapable to come to the conclusion that these bridges have to be replaced. In fact, the Army Corps' final report just stated very clearly that if we don't go in that direction within 5 or 6 years, there will be a complete closure of either one bridge or the other for an 18-month period. Think of the consequences of that, that between the two bridges, there will be a full closure, not lane closures, of one bridge or the other during that time frame, because the flatbed would have to be worked on. So it wasn't just the prospects of that dire result, but also looking at the financial aspects of that, it became clear the replacements were necessary. Because the cost of doing repair works and maintenance during this period will far exceed the cost of the replacements of the bridges. So it's a compelling story, not in terms of just the impact of the 250,000 people who live over this bridge and the islands, but also the fact that it would be a waste of taxpayer money to take a different alternative. So the conclusion is there, the end point is there. We have benchmarks that we have to continue to work towards in this process. Benchmarks like the design of these bridges, which we're saving time and money with our cooperation with the Commonwealth of Massachusetts by pooling that effort, working on it together. We signed a memorandum of understanding just last year where we're working on this together, and where when this is completed, this will be turned over as an asset, not just a federal asset at that point, but turning it over to be an asset of the Commonwealth of Massachusetts at that time. They will control and own the bridge when it's fixed. So that is ahead of us, the design work, the environmental impact on the area, and as someone that lives in Bourne, very mindful of the concern of Bourne residents. You know, Bourne is a unique community. It surprises people to know it has more coastlines than any other community in Cape Cod because of the canal. And it's a community that is divided by that canal, but it's a community brought together by the bridges. And the impact of the infrastructure, building of the bridges, as well as the state's goal on both sides of those bridges, their responsibility on that infrastructure, is going to have a very important impact on this community. And as a member of the Bourne community, I'm going to make sure that local government, Peter, you can be assured that local government is going to be part of this process and know what's going on. The people that are affected directly will know what's going on in that process. So we've had the benchmarks of where we're going, the things are processed. And as Senator Markey mentioned, not insignificantly, money is involved in this, a lot of money. And we're now at the stage where we have the road ahead, different roads ahead, or one road ahead, depending on which way we go, on the funding of this. Yesterday, in the House, to give you the latest update, we went forward with a drop-dead date of dealing with the infrastructure bill, a $2 trillion infrastructure bill, giving a commitment that that would be finalized before September 27. And we move forward in approving the $3.5 trillion budget framework that would be used in the reconciliation process, we all hope. respects, but the pools of money, I mean, the decisions were made, the funding, the bipartisan infrastructure bill, and what we hope to be able to do to reconciliation could well indeed be the vital portions of that funding going forward that are necessary. And we're going to act on those things. We're prepared to act on those things. So that I think, from my vantage point, I'm sure I share this with Senator Markey and Senator Warren, that the end point is in sight. We just have to get through these benchmarks to make sure we go forward. There's no alternative to do otherwise. So we're moving together, and we're here today to acknowledge that there are new opportunities in the offing so that we can use more revenues and more revenues available to us in this project. We'll be giving money in federal funds to the state so that the state can have greater flexibility as it goes through its many priorities, and perhaps this will be something that really helps the state a great deal and the staff into for the state portion of this. But take these words as gospel. We will replace these bridges. It is going to happen. And there's a time frame where we have to have it happen. Those 5 to 6 years, we have to deal with it. The worst of all, of course, would be to have to repair and close those bridges, and then at the same time, still have to build new bridges. So this has a time frame as well. Not a time frame that Congress has in front of it right now, but a time frame that the bridges are telling us they have. So we're happy to be here. Senator Markey mentioned all the other benefits in these different vehicles that we're going to have going forward. And they are particularly important, disproportionately so, to advantage the area that we're looking at here. Look at the coastal resiliency issues we have. Look at the difference in the way our soil is there. Look at how we're dependent on a single source aquifer and how fragile that is. We're moving together not just with our love of the environment that we share, but with both the necessity of doing this and the economic benefits of doing this. So today, to share some good news. Good news in a bipartisan sense with the infrastructure bill. Good news between the Senate and the House working together. And it's that kind of partnership going forward with the Commonwealth will be effective in getting the job done. So I want to thank you, Senator, for your efforts and how we're working together to do this. It's vital. But just as vital as these bridges are, all those other things you mentioned, because there's a time frame also in terms of climate change. And that has an answer. We have to see it as well. So we're working together on these vital issues for Cape Cod, the islands, and that region. Thank you. And looking forward to continuing to work so well together on these issues of great importance.
So now, I'm pleased to introduce our next speaker. And as everyone on Cape knows, the U.S. Army Corps, for nearly 90 years, has operated and maintained the Cape Cod bridges, working hand in hand with local, state, and federal partners. The Corps recently developed a plan for the future of travel to and from Cape Cod. And as we know, they have been great over all of the years in ensuring that these bridges work for people of Massachusetts and Cape Cod. But we need the funding. And a plan without funding is an hallucination. And the legislation which we are passing right now is going to have the funding for these bridges. So let me introduce to you Army Corps New England District Commander Colonel Adelano to discuss the Corps recommended path forward for securing a bright future for Cape Cod travel. Welcome, Colonel.
Well, Senator Markey, Congressman Keating, first of all, I'm excited to host all of you here at the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers Sagamore Recreation Area. This recreation area is one of dozens that we operate and maintain across New England, and is tied to our flood risk management mission. Part of our flood risk management mission we operate and maintain 33 dams and 3 hurricane barriers to reduce flooding throughout the region. As you know, during Hurricane Henry, preparation and investment in these large projects can make a difference in the severity of the impact of these natural disasters. In fact, our flood risk management project saved over $3 million in fiscal year 2022. Flood risk management reduces the risk to lives and property, which is critical as we adapt to changing global conditions and recognize new challenges we will face in the future. That is why we prepare for and adapt to climate change throughout the life cycle of all USAID projects. I want to thank our Cape Cod Canal team for not just hosting us today, but for the fantastic work that they do 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, operating the canal and ensuring the safety of all navigation through this canal. We have the brightest and most capable minds doing extraordinary work. This mission, as with all of our projects and programs, would not be possible without our fantastic people. We are also responsible, obviously, for the operations of the Sagamore and Warren Bridges, and we have been for the past 86 years. And we will continue to do so until both of these bridges are replaced. Last year, our headquarters, the Assistant Secretary of the Army for Civil Works, concurred with our recommendation to replace both bridges with new ones built to modern day standards. The most reliable, fiscally responsible solution for the future provides the federal government with the best long-term investment for safe access to Cape Cod for the traveling public over the next 15 years. We continue to work with Senator Markey and all of our elected officials, the Massachusetts Department of Transportation, Federal Highway Administration, to plan the next phase of the project. We look forward to working together to deliver modern, reliable bridges for residents and visitors of Cape Cod. These bridges are just two elements of a much larger, multi-purpose project of the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers, the Cape Cod Canal Federal Navigation Project. It's one of 170 federal navigation projects we operate in New England. The Cape Cod Canal is a vital federal navigation channel that enables commerce throughout New England, New York, and the East Coast. On a typical weekend in the summer, our team ensures that hundreds of large commercial carriers and recreational vessels can safely navigate the 17.5 mile canal. There are also several recreation and environmental stewardship elements to this project. I am so appreciative of our team's hard work to keep it all well-maintained and available for the enjoyment of the public. We appreciate that all Congress continues to do to balance the ongoing and ever-increasing needs that we have to operate and maintain all of our aging infrastructure across the country while making those hard decisions regarding where to allocate those funds. I cannot comment on pending legislation. One to offer that we appreciate that some of our aging infrastructure is in the discussion for the infrastructure bill. We understand the challenges that Congress is facing while making hard decisions with limited resources. I sincerely want to thank Senator Markey and our other elected officials for their continued support to the U.S. Army Corps of Engineers and for supporting all of our studies and projects across Massachusetts as we work to address our mission areas, navigation, flood risk management, recreation, environmental restoration, and environmental solution. So with that, thank you all very much for giving me the opportunity to speak.
Colonel, thank you very much. Army Corps. Now we're going to hear from State Senator Sue Moran.
Really cool happens across the canal. So I think that they'll be ringing that bell just had a very big weather event. You know, people were worried, it could the bridge actually close? You know, that was an actual question. I was at Joint Base Cape Cod with all of the, just a sea of trucks from Eversource. That's how this community mobilizes. And I just want to tell you how much I appreciate from everyone I'm looking at here in terms of members of the community, to everyone that is with me behind the podium for getting this done and moving forward. So thank you all for the opportunity.
Thank you, Senator. And again, the bill, as it passed through the Senate, was bipartisan. Ultimately, 68 members of the Senate voted for it, including Mitch McConnell. And that spirit of bipartisanship in terms of the funding that we're going to need in order to replace the bridges is present here with us today. I'd like to begin by introducing State Representative Steve Exeros for this one.
Thank you, everyone. What a beautiful, beautiful day here on Cape Cod in the 5th Barnstable District. Senator, thank you. Congressman, I love the hat. So, born Braves, if you noticed, we almost won the championship. We came close. And I'm sure Tim Whalen will tell you about the winners in Brewster. But for me, this is important in many ways. So starting out, as you know, I am a Gold Star mom. I lost my son, Nick, a Marine, at age 21. I'm wearing the parents' Purple Heart. He was killed in Afghanistan, fighting for freedom. And I'm also a former Deputy Chief of Police in the Army. So like many fellow Cape Codders, I have the ultimate respect for women who serve, and men and women. As we can see, there's something happening over there. They fight for our freedom. They serve us every day. I salute them every day. I think of my son and all that serve. And also, if you remember, last week we had the trial of Sergeant Sean Gannon, the murderer of my fellow officer was tried. And Senator Markey, I will never forget you being there for us 3 years ago. Sean Gannon was killed, and you were there, many of us were there, but I was just a cop, and I want you to know that seeing senators in Congress means a lot to us, and again, thank you. Today, I love this, so to look behind me and see that bridge, it's so important to know we'll have new ones coming. People come here to see it. They're over there watching. They relax. They do a lot, but there's also a vital role of those bridges. It fuels our economy. It creates jobs for working families. It keeps our many shops and small businesses open. For those of us that live here, the canal bridges also serve as a critical transportation link. Indeed, I know many people from this area, like said, they drive over those bridges many times a day, not just once to go somewhere and back, but they might live or work or go to school on different sides. These bridges are part of our community. They help define who we are. That's why it's important to secure the funding for the reconstruction of these bridges that you spoke so well about. We also need to make sure they're safe for those that use them and effective travel over them. And most importantly, federal funding helps us to make sure that the bridges are built and maintained without burdens on the Massachusetts taxpayer that we can avoid as much as possible. Senator Markey, on behalf of the people of the 5th Barnstable District, Sagamore Beach, right here, I want to thank you for your strong leadership. On this issue, I encourage you to do whatever you can to help our region secure the adequate federal funding. I look forward to working with you as we move forward to keep Cape Cod a beautiful, safe place to live, work, visit, and raise a family. Thank you.
Washington, when you try to decide if you're coming down to the Cape, you got to listen to the traffic report. How congested is it getting across the bridges to Cape Cod? Well, one of our goals is going to be, for once and for all, to get the design correct so people can feel confident that the traffic issues that we've seen historically are going to be dealt with. So that's also one of the beneficial parts of this whole effort that we are engaging. So I thank you, Steve. And now I'm pleased to turn the mic over to Matt Muratori, the state representative from America's hometown, Plymouth, Massachusetts.
First of all, I want to thank the Senator for having it on this side of the bridge. As a Plymouth representative, it wouldn't look good tourism-wise if I was on the other side of the bridge.
And now we're going to hear from my great friend, Representative Kathleen Lanatra. Welcome.
Senator Markey, you said traffic report from Walden. I just live in Kingston, and it's taking me 3 hours to get to visit my parents in Dennis some days. So thank you, not only for the bridges, but this whole infrastructure package. We all know as we drive around in our streets, our potholes, our sidewalks. This will really help our local municipalities. So thank you for being here. Thank you all for coming. And Kingston's right around the corner as well. So please visit Kingston. Thank you.
And our next speaker is Tim Whalen, State Representative. Welcome.
Thank you, Senator, and thanks to you and to Congressman Keating for your leadership on this very, very important project. I come here today to speak as well, to look at this from a different direction, because looking around, I believe with the exception of the police officer who just showed up from the town of Bourne, I'm the only one here who has actually leased these bridges during my years when I was assigned to the Bourne Barracks. So I've actually been out, I've put crashes on these bridges, I've done patrol on these bridges, and when the Corps of Engineers has awful construction up there doing their work, which causes massive backups. I remember being on these bridges with now Bourne Selectman, then Bourne Patrolman, Jared McDonald, working the details up there. And when the traffic came through after being stuck for an hour waiting to get over the bridge, they would all wave to us, sometimes with all five fingers. It's great. I look forward to the replacement of these bridges. I look forward very much from a safety perspective from the lanes, the width of the lanes going from 8.5 to 9 feet to going to 12 feet wide. I very much look forward to having wide open pedestrian protected walkways on these bridges. I very much look forward to having a positive median barrier between the lanes going in opposite directions, which is going to be critically important to help prevent further tragedy. I mean, as we've seen reported in the news over the years, there have been a number of head-on collisions on these bridges because of a lack of positive median barriers. So this is going to improve the flow of traffic. It's going to improve convenience. It'll certainly improve, as my good friend Paul Nitzwicki will talk very shortly about how it's going to improve commerce on the Cape. But I also just wanted to take a moment to point out how it's going to improve the safety.
The great economic benefits, which are going to flow challenges, and attitude. I know the new CEO of the college chief of the whole on the bridges.
So, Senator, assuming this legislation passes and is signed into law by the President, what kind of time frame are we looking at? I mean, that's a question for you and for the Colonel, but what would the time frame be for the place to go to?
Well, I think that, I think that because of the structural issues with the bridges, we clearly are looking at a time frame of 2025, 2026. Make a promise, but it would be our hope that by 2025.
Senator, a question for you, or perhaps Congressman Keating. Any thoughts on Congressman Wolf's trip to Afghanistan?